Here's how I built a laser tripwire circuit using a cadmium sulphide photoresistor. First, I took a dollar store laser pointer and ripped off the casing with some pliers. I soldered a negative wire just after the switch here, and soldered a positive wire right onto the laser diode's anode. This gave me a light beam that I could power from a 4.5 volt power source, or you could overvolt it with a 5 volt supply if you wanted. Next, I got hold of some photoresistors from Radio Shack. Photoresistors are components that have a different resistance depending on how much light is shining on them. The biggest one in the pack had a resistance of 4.5 kiloohms in ambient light, and around 250 ohms when a laser was shining on it. Using that information, I built this circuit that can detect when the laser beam gets broken. With the laser shining on the photoresistor, the cell's resistance is 250 ohms. So using the voltage divider equation, the voltage at the gate of the MOSFET would be 0.51 volts, so the MOSFET would stay off. When the laser path is broken, the cell resistance goes up to 4.5 kiloohms, so the voltage at the gate goes up to 3.4 volts, and the MOSFET turns on, so the gadget turns on. So anyway, here's what the circuit looked like on a breadboard, and you can see that you can use it to trigger pretty much anything you want. You can use it to trigger an LED alarm, or maybe some sort of robotic killing machine, whatever you want. So now you just need to set up your powered laser and your light sensor circuit to be pointing at each other, and you'll have a laser tripwire that can